funny way to connect other people who have started from industrialization. Who is doing this to us? Well, in a sense, we are doing it to ourselves. We're supporting it. By going, for example, by shopping in Tesco, we are supporting a system of systematic neurolinguistic programming and conditioning and what behavior modification. By going there, we're supporting it. We're doing it to ourselves. And I'm as guilty as anybody else of doing that. I'm trying my hardest to wean myself off it. It's extremely addictive. Right? It's hard, right? So, what's wrong with Tesco? Well, I'll tell you, it's not so much what's wrong with Tesco. It's what disturbs me is that you're asking that. And I have to admit, it's funny, so I was outside the world.
BBC outside broadcast.
If I go across the street to an independent shop,
okay,
where there's people on minimum wage, they're not slaves, are they? They're, you know, they're completely got their minds off,
and they're different to the
Tesco people.
Okay, fair enough, it's a good point. So his point is, if you go to an independent shop where people are on minimum wage, what's the difference? Okay, well, my response to that question is that I think you'll find that if you look hard enough, I think you'll find that there are some independent shops that actually treat their staff well. And if we were to cut down on what we consume...
And there are some good multiples in the street.
Really? There are some good multiples, you might do. Which multiples treat their people well? The people at the bottom. Goldman Sachs?
There's a publication every year with the top, I think, 100 or 250 best companies to work for.
Right.
All of them are big companies.
Really? And who decides what it means best to work for? Are they bringing out... Tell me something. You go into Starbucks and you see a beautiful human being serving in front of Starbucks and ask yourself, is this human being, you know, operating... And what percentage of this human being's potential is this human being operating as they just do their laborious task, filling your coffee up with two shots as a little hint of what coffee actually is?
Isn't the actual point to your anti-globalisation, anti-capitalist rhetoric, isn't the point that small businesses and independent businesses are vital to the economy? They employ more people, okay, than big companies. So we've got a strong independent sector anyway. But it's just that big companies, okay, are actually better at what they do, which is making money.
Okay, so big companies are better at what they do, which is making money. The only problem is with large corporations.
That's a balanced
economy. The only problem with large corporations are that they're basically fictional entities. A corporation is a fictional entity that's given, they're regarded as human beings. And so you've got a situation where you've got, for example, I was in Brighton 2 days ago, and I was doing this in the middle of the town centre, and I was told after a few minutes, some guy comes up to me and says, you can't do this. I said, why not? He says, this is private property. Who's it owned by? Standard Life. So you've got a massive insurance company controlling areas in the centre of the city. Okay? Now, these insurance companies don't have a conscience. They don't. They can't have a conscience because they're legal fictions. All they have is people working for them, and people that control them are basically likely to be sociopaths, psychopaths, who are addicted to money.
Frightening some lorries like
now,
that pull up. Never know what's inside.
Right? Why don't you speak to an alcoholic or a